Hello, everybody. My name is Sinvicta. Welcome back to Darkest Dungeon Season 4. We are finally resuming our playthrough here of our YouTube save file for the modded campaign of Season 4. Thank you, everybody, for allowing me to take a couple weeks off of Darkest Dungeon as I was feeling pretty burnt out on the game due to the Color of Madness event and also just general frustration with the game as we were leading up to the end of the last episode that you saw, which was a fun 48-round fight against a collector. Woo! So, today we are going to be starting off with an awesome challenge here. This one was submitted by Ryan Picklesimmer, who I really hope that I'm still saying that name correctly or not. I might not be. This one's entitled Spit Out the Bone, and it quite simply states the Necromancer has too many corpses to work with in the ruins, and we need to purge all the decomposing bodies. So we must complete a medium or long run in the ruins. Upon killing enemy, its corpse must be removed before moving on to the next enemy, and I must pick one mob to attack first, and then it is followed by its corpse. The corpse must be removed before moving on to the next target. And additionally, any undead or unholy mobs must be targeted before non-holy. So that means that we must go after unholy mobs first before going after against any other mob type. And of course, he also said that purging by any means necessary is also acceptable, which is the reason why we're going to be bringing Mathis here for running purge. It's also why I'm not going for a AoE, although I will say that Ryan did not say I could not use AoE. However, I am going to play it's pretty standard for this one. So on our team day, we've got Lars. Lars is going to be here for our main healing. That's the reason why I put him up front. Mathis is going to be here giving the bulk of our damage, of course, and also our corpse clearing with Purge. We might use Hulk up. We may or may not. We'll see. Mecha Tank Sock is going to be here just to help out with stress and, of course, do a little bit of damage, but nothing too crazy. And last but not least, we have Josh, who is here to basically get power leveled because we need him higher level. So I did give him the Ancestor's Portrait along with the Guardian Shield. So primarily speaking, he is going to be in the fourth position pretty much all the time and just blocking for people if we need it, but he's just here to soak up XP. So this is going to be a fetch quest for the Crest of the 1100, which is something I already have, but it did say we had to go into the ruins, and we're not able to go after... Oh yeah, I should probably put trinkets on anyone else. We're not able to do most of the other viewer challenges yet in this week, so we have a little ways to go before I can really do anything. Let's see here. Lars, we'll give him Genius Head. And we also want him healing a little bit more, so it doesn't need to be crazy heals. I think that we'd honestly just fine with Chiron's Charm or even go for a Mimic's Heart and get a little bit of extra surprise chance. Mathis, we all know what Mathis is going to be doing. Let's not get it twisted. Mathis is going straight up damage. Give him the Ravenous Lion's Ring, give him the Ancestor's Pen, all Gucci fam, as he would tell you right now if he was here, which he's not. Then for Mecha Tang Sock, we need the... Where's the cup? Did we... Does one of my jesters have my jester trinket? What happened to the tyrant's... or is that one of the... Did we lose the trinket? I think we may have actually lost that trinket. Huh. I don't remember. It's been a little while now. We had the tasting cup. And I don't know what happened to that one. I've unequipped all the trinkets, so I don't know. Either way, oh yeah, you know what? Because we lost the scroll as well, didn't we? We lost the scroll and we didn't get it back. Yeah, now I remember. Yeah, I remember that. Okay. So Mecha Tank Sock, you're gonna be a little bit gimpified, but that's okay. Let's give him a little bit of extra dodge, probably. We don't really even need it, to be quite honest. Let's see. No, we're not going to put him up front. Yeah. I guess we could just run him with more dodge on the Ancestor's Coat. So, there we go. And Andros have already kitted out. So, okay. Thank you for reminding me, game. I appreciate it. Alright, so there we go. We're not going to bring anything else here. Maybe one or two holy water, maybe a little bit of extra torches. I mean, we've got so much money on this play file, like, it doesn't even matter, really. So let's get Josh some levels. And again, thank you everybody who has been patiently waiting for the return of Darkest Dungeon. I do appreciate it. Again, I don't like playing games or doing videos whenever I feel, like, unmotivated. And I didn't want to put out, like, a substandard amount of content that wasn't really up to snuff as far as my standards are concerned.
There is power in symbols. Collect the scattered scraps of faith and give comfort to the masses.
All right, we're off and running. So just to let everybody know, in case if you missed the announcement on the last video or whenever it was that I think I did it on the channel update not long ago.
The light gains purchase,
this will be the final week that you'll be able to nominate four viewer challenges. So get in your beer challenges. This week will be the final week that you can submit them. So if you've been holding out some doozies, now's the time. Then next week we're going to go through doing all the viewer challenges from this week, and then after that, season four will probably come to a close.
Inspiration and improvement.
All right, Josh is going to bolster everyone. All right, so since none of these are unholy, we can basically just go for just one of them.
Blow.
Good bleed there by Lars. Now, we do not have to go after the one that's in front. We can go for any target, but we have to destroy the target's corpse before we go on to the next target. Everyone going after Josh here. Why they're going after Josh, I'm not sure, but the game knows, man. The game knows. Skewer there on Mathis. Big damage. Didn't get the bleed, though, and I'm fine with that. There we go. Josh going to use Command. Command's going to buff the Axe and crit, by the way. Let's get a heal on Mathis. Didn't get the bleed on Lars himself, which is a little bit unfortunate. And I'd prefer to let this one actually die. That way there's no corpse. So I'm going to go ahead and take a knee here. And we're going to let this corpse go away of the supplicant before we even do anything else.
Slowly,
there we go.
Gently. This is how a life is taken.
Now I may end up switching over to Hugh, because if we get a double kill, then that's fine. I mean, Ryan didn't say that I couldn't use AoE. Let's see here. Lars, over the back one. And we can also get a bleed here from Mecha Tank's up. One off lethal, count it. If you're wondering why I'm spreading out the damage here, it's basically because... Oh wow, Josh got the debuff. I was not expecting that. It's basically because we don't have to... Something else I should mention in the challenge is that we don't have to straight up kill our target. We have to kill once a target dies. That is when we have to take care of the corpses. We can actually go for multiple targets if we want to, as long as it's AoE, I believe. All right, so here let's just let Lars take that one out. Mathis will have to purge the corpses. Or corpse, I should say. But he can't do that because he's not in the first position. Alright, well.
The wounds of war can be healed, but never hidden.
And actually, now that I reread that, you must pick one mob to attack first, followed by the corpse. Okay, so we can only pick one. I apologize. This is the first fight. You gotta let me get it ingrained in my head. So we can only attack one target at a time. Got it. I was rereading that, I just want to make sure. Mathis 43, big crit.
As victories mount, so too will resistance.
So apologies to Ryan, I should have known that. I needed to reread that. Alright, I'm going to put Mathis up front because we need him to use Purge. We did get scouting here, which is good. That means we're going to be able to find our quest item. Quest location 1, there we go. Alright, so there's no reason for us to go down here. Again, we don't need gold on the save file. We're just basically going through, plugging away. Now, if you're wondering when am I planning on going into the Crimson Court, that is going to be for next week. So basically what I'm trying to say is, if you have any challenges that you want specifically for the Crimson Court, now's the time. I'm not planning on going to the Crimson Court this week.
Wealth beyond measure. Awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike.
Alright, so we have the infamous blood letter and the raider and the hunter. Alright, let's see here. Let's let, I want Lars to start bleeding here. Or not. Right, Josh, go ahead and bolster everyone up. Mecha Tank Sock going after the bleed, so this is the target that I have selected for ourselves. Nathan's gonna Hulk up. Quad dodge, the game is not gonna be happy about that. They were able to very easily hit 368 dodge. Let's go figure on that. Point blank shot on Mathis.
Such a terrible assault cannot be.
Back to back crits must be nice.
The blood quickens.
All right, Lars, really need you to start taking damage here. Blanket fire. Another quad dodge. Don't worry, game. You've already gotten your money's worth. And yeah, they're just going to keep on critting because, you know, it's not like we're at Radiant Light or anything. Any day, Mathis. Josh is going to guard Mathis, which is something I thought I'd never say. We need to get this bloodletter out of here. Point blank shot. It's going to be redirected to Josh. Alright, we can take the mark and the bleed away from Mecha Tank Sog. Yeah, I think buffing up again would probably be wise. Josh gonna go ahead and give commands to everybody. Mathis with a 69 crit. There we go. Good job, Mathis. That's what we needed from you. Another quad dodge. Again, I'm not going to feel sorry for the game at this point, because this freaking raider keeps critting all the time. I think Lars is able to finally get a full heal here. Not a full heal, but you know what I mean. Good heal there by Lars. Let's start taking away some of this stress. Mathis got a crit heal on the heal over time from Lars. It gets a crit dunk there on the raider. Nicely done, Mathis. About time. We needed you, Mathis. Rush shot. This hunter has shot four times and has not done a single point of damage. And that's what I like. That's what I like to see. Keep on command. Remember, command does indeed increase the amount of crit that Mathis gets. Yeah, 60 crit. See you later. Mathis, the world breaker. Everyone knows it.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer.
You know what? Not even gonna worry about it. We don't need gold. I don't need mimics. Quest locations in the next room. That's good. Again, we don't need gold, so yeah, I don't really care.
The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it.
Alright, let's get a heal on Mecha Tank Sock. Still didn't get the bleed on Lars, unfortunately.
A brilliant confluence of skill and purpose.
Josh gonna bolster everyone. He's gonna increase their dodge and their speed. Swing gonna miss. Mathis actually dodged. And so did Lars. Two of the non-dodgiest characters in all this game just dodged back-to-back. Josh got pulled up, unfortunately. So Mathis is gonna Hulk up. Now, what's nice about the Man-at-Arms is that we are able to move them basically wherever we want. Just get all the heals over time. Mathis, 30 non-crit. He did leave a corpse here, though. So, I think Josh, we're just going to move backwards here. I actually got the bleed on Mathis, which is pretty incredible. Mathis, what is your bleeding resist? Oh, 70. Never mind. It's not that incredible. So here, I think that we can elect to get this bleed off of Mathis with Lars. He's also going to take the mark. That's fine. Now we have to go for this corpse. As much as I don't want to, we have to go for the corpse first. So I'm gonna have Mathis use Purge here.
As the theme
apparently
calls,
Purge can crit
a faint hope
for a whole
blossoms.
Lot. Well, I was doing that to clear the corpse, not actually get that kill there. I didn't even realize that Purge dealt damage, to be quite honest. But now I do. alright. I did not know that Purge dealt damage. I don't know why I didn't know that. And it's a knockback of 3 as well. Man, I learned something new today. Alright, so maybe we don't need Purge, because I'm just going to use Chop anyway. Although, no, that doesn't make sense, because we can still keep Purge, doesn't really matter. Mathis, 60 crit, thank you very much.
Give them no quarter.
Thanks for playing. Let's eat some of this food here. Now, Mathis will eat more food when we camp, because he's got the Ravenous Lion's Ring. I'm gonna let Lars bleed, obviously. We want him to be somewhat low health. So we can get off those juicy, juicy heals that Flagellants can get. Or Flagellants. Alright, whichever way you want to pronounce it. Doesn't matter to me. Get dodged by Mecha Tank Sock. Alright, let's see. We really don't need a heal, so I guess we're gonna go after the shield wall. Nice crit there by Lars. Spear thrust on Lars, brings him to one off lethal. Slash on Mathis. And axe blade on Lars.
Perched at the very precipice of oblivion.
Mathis is gonna Hulk up here. Obviously, we're gonna have to heal. Go ahead and do that. Lars is back up. No problem at all. Mathis gets the 33 crit.
Broken. Maintain the offensive.
No more shield wall for you. We don't have to worry about a corpse. They were able to actually hit Mecha Tank Sock, which is pretty impressive when you think about it. Mathis gets pushed back there by the Spearman attack. They're able to hit Mecha Tank Sock pretty easily. I mean, 68 dodge isn't like that much, but you would think that, like, you know, a debuff there. By the way, Bellow does reduce the speed and the dodge by a whole lot. We need to take out the Lancer next. Alright. I was gonna say, it sucks that we don't have a bleed. Or it sucks that we do have a bleed, but it doesn't even matter, apparently. Mana jab on Lars. Swing, gonna miss. Man, those heals over time, when they crit, that's some good stuff. Really good. I mean, if you think about it, that's almost a crit. That's almost as good as an AoE crit heal from, like, a vessel. Like, if you can get an 8 on the AoE from a vessel, you're, like, way ahead of the curve. And Mathis is just going to get scarier and scarier with every command that Josh gets. Lars can't heal himself, so I guess we'll heal Mathis again. Still can't get the bleed. Alright, Mathis, this is what you've been waiting for. You're hulked up, ready to go. And he hit for 17 on crit. Of course. And they crit for 21.
About to break.
And they get reinforcements. Alright, way to go, Mathis. Good job. The one time that we're like, hey, we actually really, really need a crit, Mathis just fires a big old goose egg. Mathis still didn't crit, amazingly. So now we have to get rid of this corpse before we can do anything else. And apparently they're just going to keep critting Lars, so... Might need to get Mecha Tank Sock in on this action. There we go. Lars takes out the corpse. And any day, Mathis. Any day. Dodge by Josh. Thank you, Mathis. I shouldn't have to thank you, though, Mathis. You should have done that like 2 hits ago. Tank Sock taking down Lars of Stress. That's probably the only time I should have gone for a punish, but Mathis got it done anyway.
These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten.
And we need to get rid of some torches there. Alright. Oh yeah, I forgot we have the mod that stacks them. Oh well. We have extra deeds now. Hooray. Yeah, that's really good. The fact that at the base level, it still hits for 4. By it, I mean the heal over time. That's really, really good. That's a surprising amount of healing. And we found the last reliquary here. So, look at that. Easy peasy, no problem at all. Good job, team. That was no sweat at all.
The abbot will be grateful. The trappings of his faith have been restored.
There we go. Josh got 2 levels. I clicked a little bit too fast. I was trying to see if he got any negative quirks.
Take advantage of this faith-fueled charity. It will not last.
So there you go. And we should have an extra bonus for this week only. No, maybe not. All Saints Day. The Abbey will be decorated in duration of the event. To visit extended hours. So the Abbey is going to get a little bit of a buff there. Baynard is apparently going on a summer retreat. By the way, I did hold on to these occultists just in case if we need them. I mean, I don't want to, but there you go on that. So anyway, I'm going to do a little bit of house cleaning here. Thank you again, everyone. Remember, as a quick reminder, this is the final week that you can submit viewer challenges for Season 4, and I will be going into the Crimson Court next week. So, and by the way, don't give me like, oh, you got to do a full clear in one video or in one breath or something like that, but try to make them Crimson Court-esque. But it doesn't have to be used in Crimson Court, though. So, again, thank you all very much for the patience and allowing me to delay Season 4 a little bit. I needed the break. We're back in it now, and I'm ready to finish out Season 4. Phenomenal season. Phenomenal support. Thank you all very much for being here. Until next time, so long, everybody!